I'm Satan himself.
A what?
I'm Satan. I'm Lucifer.
the last humans. Who, in their right mind, Kevin, could possibly deny the 20th century was entirely mine?
All of it, Kevin! All of it.
Mine. I'm big. It's my time.
Thank you. before us an ordeal of the most grievous kind. I will say to the house, I have nothing to offer but blood, toil, tears, and sweat. You ask, what is our policy? I would say, it is to wage war. To wage war by sea, land, air, with all our might, with all the strength that God can give us. To wage war against the monstrous tyranny that never surpassed in the dark a lamentable catalogue of human crime. That is our policy. You ask, what is our aim? I can answer in one word, victory. Victory at all costs. Victory in spite of all terror. Victory however long or hard the road may be. For without victory, there is no survival. We are resolved to destroy Hitler and every vestige of the Nazi regime. From this, nothing will turn us. Nothing. We will never parley. We will never negotiate with Hitler or the grisly gang that feeds his wicked will. We shall fight him by sea. We shall fight him in the air until, with God's help, we have rid the earth of his shadow.
Secrecy is repugnant in a free and open society, and we are as a people inherently and historically opposed to secret societies, to secret oaths, and to secret proceedings. We decided long ago the dangers of excessive and unwarranted concealment of pertinent facts far outweighed the dangers which are cited to justify it. Even today, there is little value in opposing the threat of a closed society by imitating its arbitrary restrictions. Even today, there is little value in ensuring the survival of our nation if our traditions do not survive with it. And there is very grave danger that an announced need for increased security will be seized upon by those anxious to expand its meaning to the very limits of official censorship and concealment. That I do not intend to permit, to the extent that it is in my control. And no official of my administration, whether his rank is high or low, civilian or military, should interpret my words here tonight as an excuse to censor the news, to stifle dissent, to cover up our mistakes, or to withhold from the press and the public the facts they deserve to know. For we are opposed around the world by a monolithic and ruthless conspiracy that relies primarily on covert means for expanding its sphere of influence, on infiltration instead of invasion, on subversion instead of election, on intimidation instead of free choice, on guerrillas by night instead of armies by day. It is a system which has conscripted vast human and material resources into the building of a tightly knit, highly efficient machine that combines military, diplomatic, intelligence, economic, scientific, and political operations. Its preparations are concealed, not published. Its mistakes are buried, not headlined. Its dissenters are silenced, not praised. No expenditure is questioned, no rumor is printed, no secret is revealed. No president should fear public scrutiny of his program, for from that scrutiny comes understanding, and from that understanding comes support.
People, how you feeling? Party people, how you feeling?
Now?